Hey guys, Alex from 7th Hour Films back again with Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. Last time around, we had Backs in the Distance, where basically we were continuing on with luring in the homunculi, and Lanfan was injured, but not killed. Luckily, she was able to slightly counter Bradley's attack, and then Ling Yao was pretty much on his own trying to fend off Wrath and Gluttony. Cutting back over to Scar and as he faced the Elric boys, Winry showed up. Somehow she made her way into the middle of the battle, but whatever, not important. And we basically got Scar's backstory, how he saw the corruption of his people to alchemy, and, you know, because they wanted to use alchemy against state alchemists, basically. And he saw that as a corrupting force, and eventually his people were attacked by one of the alchemists, and because of that, his brother fused his right arm onto Scar, and when he awoke, he was pretty much had a lot of trauma left over, and lashed out, and unfortunately killed the Rockbells in the middle of that. And yeah, that was pretty much that, and that explains his right arm. It's the deconstructing arm of his brother. So yeah, and Winry heard all this story, and heard that he was the one who killed her parents, and was going to shoot, but she couldn't do it, and Scar started to escape. Al went after him, and Ed stayed behind to comfort Winry. So yeah. It was a crazy episode. Crazy, crazy good episode. But yeah, that was pretty much that. Like always, the reaction is down in the description and in the pinned comment for your viewing pleasure. So let's go ahead and jump right into this episode of Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. Here we go. Jesus. Well, that is terrifying. I mean, that just looked like the portal. I think, or something. Give me a sec. Get over to the second page. Okay. Oh, hey. All right. Mei Chang is Monica Rial. Ooh. Oh, that's awkward. Yoki and Tetsu. I don't know who they are. I feel like we've looked up Nox before, so I guess we're good. Have we ever looked up Gluttony? Well, I see he plays Shu in Dragon Ball Super Broly. He also played, I guess, original Mr. Popo and Tien in, oh god, in Dragon Ball? Nope. Alright. Well, it's always good to look. Always good to look and see. But, yeah. Alright. Jesus. What an episode, you know? What an episode. Yeah, what a freaking episode, man. That was crazy. So, huh. I mean, just like, just everything just kind of going to shit. Okay. Interesting stuff. I'm gonna sort of group some of these notes together. Let's start off with Lanfan. Jesus! Jesus, girl. That is fucking crazy. That is fucking crazy. So, it was her idea, I suppose. It must have been her idea to cut her own arm off, and then she uses his jacket to try to quell the bleeding as much as she can, and until she can get a doctor. But yeah, Jesus Christ! So she cut her arm off. They tied it to a dog, And then the dog led Raph astray. So, Jesus. And yeah, she's lost her arm. She's lost her arm. And I love that that is actually a callback to when Ed tries that on her. When she picks up his automail arm and then he gets the drop on her. She did that, but with her own flesh and blood, literally. Jesus Christ. And yeah, the whole thing of like, oh, well, like, I guess I'm going to need a new arm. And it's like, well, we know a good engineer. And it's like, yeah, she already left. God damn it. Oh, well. I mean, Ling's kind of running out of people because Fu isn't back. You know, I assume Fu is coming back at some point from escorting Maria Ross to Xing. So, but yeah. But yeah, that's fucking crazy. So, yeah, Lan Fan has lost her arm. Jesus. We got a bit of Al standing up for alchemy and saying, like, oh, it's because of alchemy that I was saved, you know? I was saved in this body. It's not perfect, but I still believe in it, which was interesting. And then we get Scar versus Gluttony, which, honestly, Scar kind of has one of the best, I guess, because he has one of the most destructive forms, basically, because it is just destruction, you know? So yeah, like, if he had just kept doing that to Gluttony, you just kind of wonder, eventually, I suppose, he would run out, you know? If the Philosopher's Stones are based on the souls that are put in them, basically acting as, you know, lives in a video game, and yeah, that's pretty much how Roy beat Lust, was running out her lives in the Philosopher's Stone. So if you can do that to Gluttony, then there you go. So that was interesting. And they figured out how to take Gluttony. I do like that. That Ling Yao figured out, as long as his body is expanding, he'll be stuck in that wire. So that was clever. Mei Chang is back. When did we first meet Mei Chang? Like, that was a while ago, wasn't it? Let me look. Yeah, it was episode 15. This is 23, so yeah, it has been quite a while. And yeah, Mei Chang never showed up after that. So it has been quite a while since we last saw Mei Chang. I mean, I guess it's also kind of been a while since we saw Scar, too. And he's only come back recently, so I like that Scar has Mei Chang. That's just very interesting that they're just kind of palling around. He seems to be okay with her alkahestry and stuff. And yeah, her alkahestry, which is very interesting, because it seems that she's connecting it with knives, basically. So all of her knives, this is just my theory, is that all of her knives are connected. So she throws them in a circle on certain points, throws down another transmutation circle. Whatever happens here then happens where those knives are too. That must be it. So, of course, that does have the thing of, well, you need to draw out this circle and put down the knives and everything. But still, that's a very, very, that's a very, very interesting thing, you know? And I guess, see, I'm so curious as to why Scar is so okay with her alkahestry. And maybe, I mean, yeah, he has a problem with alchemy, but alkahestry, especially in Xing, it seems they've kind of always said it's more medical, you know? It's always used for more medical uses, never really for combat. It's only in Amestis that it's, you know, been sort of militarized with state alchemists, you know? So perhaps Scar views alkahestry as not corrupting, you know? Because even still, they have all these powers of alkahestry, but, you know, if you're looking for immortality, you have to look somewhere else, you know? Alkahestry will not get you that. So that could be it, that Scar is just more lenient with that, you know? Or Or it could even just be the fact that even if he doesn't like Alkahestery, that's Xing. You know, that's Xing. He's focused on Amestis, you know? He's focused on Amestis and the State Alchemists and the Fuhrer and everything, so he has more of a grudge against, you know, the ones who committed the genocide, the atrocities towards his people. So I guess it would be more that. But yeah, that's all really interesting. We're keeping the panda. I like that. That was really funny. We're keeping the panda. I don't remember the panda's name, unfortunately. But I like that Al was able to catch it. And then, yeah, it's all mad and it tries biting his finger. And it's like, oh, yeah, Al doesn't feel anything, so it doesn't even matter. So I did like that. They explained everything to Winry. And, yes, it was rough, but it's good that she knows that now. Her parents, they died as they lived, helping people. So I like that. And then she's headed back to Rush Valley to help the people. Because, yeah, you know, she said in this episode, it's like, you know, do I just have to wait for everything, you know? Like, I just have to sit here and wait. There's nothing I can do. But there is something she can do, even if not for Ed or Al or to be in this fight, she can help people, you know? And I like that. So she's going to go back, and apparently she's just that damn good of an engineer. So, but I like that. That was really good. Of course, if she had stuck around, you know, one more day so that she could get Lanfan a new arm. Although, I would imagine she may not even have the proper equipment. Like, she can service Ed's arm, you know, fix it up, but if you're getting an entirely new arm and everything, then yeah, it may be better just to go to Rush Valley, you know, get the cream of the crop, as Macho Man used to say. RIP. Anyway, yeah, so that would, I could understand that it is probably better to go to have Lanfan sent to Rush Valley in order to get a really good arm, you know? The good thing also, too, is I would imagine her arm wouldn't need to be serviced too much. Like, mainly not compared to Ed. Because while, yes, she would be fighting with it, she would be fighting with that arm a lot. I just imagine the fact that, you know, it's not going to be used for alchemy or anything would also be part of it, you know? But I don't know. But she definitely needs to go do that. But that was a good sort of send-off. I mean, I say, wow, that, you know, that's a good send-off for Winry. We've done that like 5 times now, and she keeps coming back. So I'm sure within the next 10 episodes, we're either going to go back to Winry or she's going to show up for something. But yeah, like, there is this constant back and forth, and it's fine. This isn't a bad thing. But there's always seems to be a constant, like, all right, bye, Winry. You go off, and we'll go do our thing. Oh, wait, here she is. Like, 5 episodes later, she's back. So, yeah. It's all fine. It's just kind of interesting. This is, like, the 8th time we've said goodbye to Winry, you know? But I did like that send-off, and then the whole thing of, like, oh, the next time I make you cry, you'll be crying tears of joy. Because we'll have our bodies back, and that's a promise. And I like that, because, yeah, you know, when Ed's saying, it's like, I made her cry again. I fucked up and I made her cry, you know? It's like he keeps fucking up, but he tries to do better. I fucking love Ed. I love Ed. Anyway. So yeah, what else do we got? We did have the whole thing of who gets the Philosopher's Stone. Lanfan and Ling, because, you know, they literally lost an arm for that. Roy, because it can help Havoc. Ed and Al, because it could help get their bodies back, all that sort of stuff. So there is a bit of debate over who should get the stone, but then fucking Gluttony realizing that Roy was the one who killed Lust. Just, I don't even know what. Like, I don't even know what. Like, he opened and it looked like the portal, you know, where the truth was. And then, I don't know, like, half the house and the car is gone. Like, I don't know. I don't know what the hell he did, but it's pretty crazy. It's pretty crazy. So, yeah. That'll be really interesting to see what's going on next episode. Other than that, we did get the reveal to the gang that the Fuhrer is most likely a homunculus. And also the whole thing with his son being adopted, so that lends itself to that. We had the whole thing of Risa. Jesus, I couldn't think for a second. Risa's disguise of the, like, the lab jacket and the glasses. I love that that's, you know, it's literally the Clark Kent glasses trying to fool people. But that does not get past the Ultimate Eye. So, not that he used the Ultimate Eye. He was just like, wait a minute. That girl looks familiar. I think she's one of Mustangs, you know? So, yeah. So that was interesting. But yeah, I guess that's pretty much it. Again, another crazy action-packed episode. But yeah, really, really enjoy it, and I can't wait to see where we are going next time. But that is basically it. With all that being said, I'm Alex from Seventh Hour Films, and I will see you guys next time. Take care. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video. There's a bunch of links on screen if you want to go click around to any of those. There's a playlist for all of my Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood reactions, as well as another video you can go click on if you want. There's also a subscribe button and a Patreon button on screen, as well as other links in the description if you want to go check out any of those. See you guys later.